This is Brett Strong. I'm going to be talking about the fallacies of Amy Orr Ewing.
I have met Jesus Christ.
She works for Ravi Zacharias. Nice young lady married to Frog, her husband's name. They have several hundred kids together. I think like 3, 4, or 5, I don't know. But nice young lady, smart. But she speaks a lot of things she claims to be real, but it's just fiction.
I have met Jesus Christ.
It's just imaginary.
I have met Jesus Christ.
Yes, Amy Orr Ewing has an imaginary friend named Jesus.
I have met Jesus Christ.
Who she claims she experiences.
I have met Jesus Christ.
I guess from time to time. Here, I'll play it for you, and I'll take it on the other side.
The response I would say to that is that Christian certainty is not based on a kind of factual gaining of...
Let me stop right there. Notice you said that Christianity is not based on facts, like evidence. You want to know why she says that? Because there is no facts. There is no hardcore evidence for Jesus, God. Nothing. It's all assumption. So she's very smart to sit there and go, well, when it comes down to my faith and Christian's faith, it really has nothing to do with evidence. It has to do with, she's going to say it, personal experience. Check it out. She's very wise. Christians are very wise to skip the evidence stuff when you push them to the wall, because there is no evidence for Jesus. The first century knows nothing of Jesus, especially when he's supposed to walk this earth up until 30 AD. Nothing. No one wrote about him. No one said anything about him. No one cared about him. He's not listed. First of all, he's fiction because he's a superhero, flying in the air, disappearing through walls, walking on water. And if there was a human being, Jesus, he definitely got crucified and the dogs ate his body. But anyway, she's very smart to use, well, if you're going to push me to the wall, okay, forget evidence. Yeah, she's right, because there is no evidence. So she's going to go to La La Land. Imaginary friend, here she goes.
Of evidences and facts, it's based on an encounter with a person.
See? It's based on an encounter with a person. A personal experience. William Lane Craig loves to say it. Matter of fact, William Lane Craig will flat out tell you, like, hey, at the end of the day, it has nothing to do with evidence or arguments. His faith relies on a personal experience. Amy Orr Ewing is saying the exact same thing. That her faith, at the end of the day, forget evidence, forget facts, is in a personal experience. And like I said, she's very smart to say that, because there is no evidence or facts for Jesus and God. So Christians like her have no choice but to go into the imaginary realm. I mean, because who can defeat the imaginary realm? Because all you have to say, well, hey, it's my personal experience. It's like someone saying, I had a personal experience with Spider-Man. He's real. He flies off building. Yeah, I know people say he's fiction and they write and they have fictional books and movies, but he's real. How do you know he's real? One would ask. And the person goes, well, I know Spider-Man is real because I have a personal experience. Or, you know, someone could say the same thing about Superman, Incredible Hulk. Name it. Name. You can create any being, person you want, and say, well, okay, forget evidence and facts, okay? Forget it. I had a personal experience with Spider-Man or Superman or the Incredible Hulk. See? That's exactly what Amy Orr Ewing is doing. Skip facts, skip evidence. I had a personal experience with this man named Jesus, and there you go. Imaginary friend. I would say to Amy Orr Ewing, like, okay, obviously, I just showed how fallacious that saying is by saying I had a personal experience. That is totally fallacious. I've already said that. But I would say to Amy Orr Ewing, and William Lane Craig, but especially I'm talking about Amy Orr Ewing, how did Jesus look? You said you had a personal experience with Jesus.
I have met Jesus Christ.
How does he look? Does he have brown eyes, green eyes, blue eyes? Does he have long hair, curly hair? Is he dark skin, light skin? I mean, archaeologists who look up bones from the first century say that the average male Jew Palestinian was about 5'3", 110 pounds. So Jesus would have been about 5'3", 110 pounds. So I would say Amy Orr Ewing. You said you had a personal experience with Jesus. How tall is he? Is he 5'3", 110 pounds? Curly hair, dark skin? I mean, 2,000 years ago, right? He came there. So how, Amy Orr Ewing, does he have gray hair? Does he have wrinkly skin? Does he have an oxygen tank? I mean, is he in a wheelchair? I mean, did you feed him food? Because last time in Luke, he ate fish with the disciples. So Amy Orr Ewing, you say this Jesus is real and you had a personal experience. And you need to explain yourself. You need to pontificate upon that. Just can't say, well, I had a personal experience and that's it. Well, you can say it because it's all fiction. But, you know, if you're going to debate me, I'm going to say, well, let's talk about that personal experience. How did he look?
I have met Jesus Christ.
How tall was he? How short was he? Did he have stab wounds from 2,000 years ago when he told his disciples in the fictional gospels, hey, touch my hands and my feet and my side? I mean, does he still have nail holes in his hands and feet? Does he still have a spear wound in his side? I mean, is it rotten? I mean, does he need a tourniquet? I mean, 2,000 years with an open wound in your hands, feet, and side, that's pretty, I think you might need some medical attention. Folks, are you starting to see how ridiculous Amy Orr Ewing is to sit there and claim, well, I had a personal experience with Jesus. That makes Jesus real. I had a personal experience with Jesus, and you can't take it away.
I have met Jesus Christ.
Fine, Amy. I won't take it away. Your imaginary friend. Keep him. Let's go on real quick. She's going to keep talking about her imaginary friend.
And so one Christian apologist, William Lane Craig, talks about it in terms of the difference between knowing and showing. We can demonstrate that we believe our worldview is the best possible explanation of reality, that it stands up to scrutiny. We can show with evidence, with argument, etc. But we know on a different basis. We know something personally. So when a Christian talks about certainty, they're talking about, you know, I have met Jesus Christ. So
see, she just said it again. I have met Jesus Christ. So everything I just said before I played that piece stands. How tall is he? What color are his eyes? What does he smell like? Is he old? Does he have wounds still in his body? Does he have wrinkly skin? Does he have an oxygen tank? Is he in a wheelchair? I mean, how does he go in and out of existence? I mean, that he defies science, disappearing in thin air, appearing out of thin air. I mean, she just said it. A personal experience with Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ in Luke, when he rose again in the book of Luke, the storybook, when he rose again, he was flesh and bone. He was not this spirit being, he was flesh and bone. You see how when you flush out Amy Orr Ewing beliefs, her personal experiences, when you flush out her personal experience, it looks ridiculous because it is, folks. But it's okay, Amy Orr Ewing. I understand you. Life is tough. And if you need a superhero character, an imaginary friend with superhero powers, if you need that to get you through life, by all means, Amy Orr Ewing, please keep believing in your superhero Jesus character. Keep believing in your imaginary friend. Seriously. I tell all Christians, hey, if you need a superhero imaginary friend to make you feel loved and help you get through life, life is tough, so I understand it. So I understand Amy Orr Ewing. But, you know, if she's going to promote this as being legitimate, come on. It's like a little kid saying, I have an imaginary friend. Ooh, what do we all do when we hear a kid saying they have an imaginary friend? We pat them on their head and we go about our way. We don't even pay them any mind because we know, like, come on, there's no such thing as an imaginary friend. Come on. Let's go a little further. Because Amy Orr Ewing, she takes it to another level. She goes from her imaginary Jesus, you know, little guy from first century, 2,000-year-old guy. You know, she says she has a personal experience with some 2,000-year-old guy. And she goes, okay. And then she skips over to the Holy Ghost. I mean, here we go, folks.
And so you talk, you read a book, and if my wife did that, you know, I read, you know, read notes that she'd written years ago, and I phoned her up and nobody answered. I'd think either she was dead or had left me or something. You know,
I suppose the Christian answer to that is the role and person of the Holy Spirit, that Jesus promises that when he goes, he leaves the Comforter. Yeah. And so the Christian experience, I mean, and obviously you can question that.
You see, she starts to stutter because she realizes the guy's going to call her on it. Like, come on, seriously, the Holy Spirit now? You go from some flesh and bone superhero Jesus, 2,000 years old, with wounds in his hands, feet, and side, and disappears. I mean, this superhero character in the Bible, and now you switch over to the Holy Ghost. Wow. The desperate measures Christians will go to stick to their beliefs. Let me just play a little bit more.
Is it again? It comes back down to experience.
See, the guy called it experience. The guy, experience. Why? Because you can hide away with that. You can hide away, well, it's my personal experience. I don't need evidence or facts to prove to you that my personal experience is real. Well, neither does the person who says that Spider-Man and Superman is real. Or the Incredible Hulk is real. That they could claim the same thing Amy Orr Ewing is doing. My personal experience. You see, when you flesh out, it's what Greg calls tear off the roof. Tear off the roof is to take what somebody says to the fullest extent. And if it becomes ridiculous when you take it to the fullest extent, then it should not be believed. It should be, you know, as it is, false. Like, this is false. So when you take the roof off of Amy Orr Ewing, personal experience, Jesus, when you follow it all the way out, as I just talked about, it's foolish. But let me just play a little bit more of Amy Orr Ewing.
And we can all claim experiences of all sorts of things, which are not necessarily tied into reality.
But yes, I mean, of course that's true. But again...
See, she admits it. See, of course that's true, that we can all claim these ridiculous things. And see, she understands it. Like, yeah, of course, you heard her. She just said, yeah, of course it's true that we can all claim these ridiculous things. But, you know, her God is, I mean, her experiences, it's real. So she's saying her experience is real, but she will discount anyone else saying their experience of it. I could say, hey, Zeus is real. How do you know Zeus is real? Well, I've met his son, his only begotten son, Zeus Jr. Where's the facts and evidence for Zeus Jr.? I don't need any facts or evidence for Zeus Jr. I had a personal experience with Zeus Jr. And Zeus Jr. is real because I experienced him. Therefore, Zeus is real. That's utter ridiculous, right? Well, that's exactly what Amy Orr Ewing is doing. Man, Amy Orr Ewing is a nice lady. Intelligent. But sometimes, intelligent people can believe the most ridiculous things in the world. And this is a perfect example of an intelligent young lady believing mere fiction as being real. It's like she's a kid believing Santa Claus. That's what her Jesus is. It's just an ancient version of our modern day Santa Claus. And just like kids buying a Santa Claus, she's buying into the ancient version of Santa Claus called Jesus, the New Testament superhero flying in the air, disappearing through walls, walking on water. I mean, 2,000 years ago, he said he's supposed to come back surfing the clouds. No Jesus surfing the clouds. He's supposed to come back on a flying white horse with an army flying on their horses too. 2,000 years ago. It ain't happened. You know why, folks? Because Jesus is fiction. Jesus is fiction. But it's okay, Amy Orr Ewing. Keep your imaginary friend. But don't promote this as being true. Just say, hey, my imaginary friend is true for me. And just leave it at that. Don't be dogmatic talking about hell, obey the Bible, yada yada. Just enjoy your imaginary friend Amy Orr Ewing, and you'll do just fine. This is Brad Strong signing off.